Okay, what's up you guys? It's Molly. Welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you're new. If you're new here, my name's Molly. I'm a freshman at the University of Alabama, and it's kind of crazy to think about, but I really only have a few weeks left of this semester, which is absolutely crazy that my first semester of college is done. It literally feels like yesterday I got dropped off, and I was just kind of thinking about this past semester and everything that's kind of happened and the things I've learned. And because I was kind of thinking back about all this stuff, I decided to make a video for you guys called What I Wish I Knew Before My First Semester of College. I have kind of just realized a lot of things and things from high school that translate, which is really good advice for seniors, things that I kind of just wish I knew beforehand. Some are specific to here, some are kind of for everywhere, I feel like. So that's what I'm gonna do for you guys today. Give this video a thumbs up afterwards if you want me to do one at the end of the year to kind of compare and see if these things are similar. But I have a huge list on my phone of different things that I thought of that would be good to share with you guys. So that is what we're gonna do today. So without further ado, let's jump right into the video. Okay, so the first one, especially right after move-in, make a routine. This for me, I feel like was very important because I have always been like a very routine-oriented person. I like knowing what I'm doing, and when I came and moved in, obviously this is normal for every college freshman. You're kind of like, what am I doing? This feels so weird. I'm not at home. Like, you have to start making a routine, and that really helps it feel like home very, very fast. Like when I left for fall break, which was 3.5 months after I moved in, I felt like I really had a routine down here, so it was almost weird going home. So it definitely is helpful to make a routine because it helps your adjustment to school and everything else a lot better. The next thing is, it's okay to be homesick. It is completely normal. If you are a senior going to college next year and you're watching this, I promise you, everyone is feeling the same way you are. I've learned that very easily. I mean, I bawled my eyes out when I like got dropped off. I was a mess, but, and there are moments I'm still kind of like, I kind of wish I was home, but it's like you slowly make your school your home, and I've already started to feel that. But there are moments in every college kid's life where they're kind of like, I miss home. I miss like the familiarity of it all, and it's completely normal. And just like talk to people about it, talk to your friends about it, because they're probably feeling the same way, and chances are a lot of them aren't talking about it with you because they don't think you're feeling the same way. They don't think people around them are feeling the same way. Just know it's completely normal. The next thing is, it's not as easy to make friends as people say. I feel like this one is very dependent on your choice to do Greek life or not. I obviously did Greek life and I love it, and I have advice for that coming up also, but you really do have to get out there and meet people, and then you can kind of develop that, like, okay, I'll just hang out with this person, like, you really do have to do that, because at the beginning, everyone's kind of trying to make friends, and that's like when you make your first like friends, is like that initial like reaching out and like going out and meeting those people. So I definitely just encourage that. For me, because I'm in a suite style dorm, I think it is a little harder to make friends in this style of a dorm, just because you aren't a communal dorm. You're not sharing a bathroom with like 100 other people. You have your own bathroom. You're kind of like, when you're in your dorm, you're in your dorm. That might just be me, but that's my experience. I feel like a suite style dorm, it's a little bit harder to make friends in that way. Like, people in communal dorms are always saying how they meet people all the time, and I don't really feel like that's the case here for me, but that's just some advice that I have about that. The next one is, coming so far from home makes you grow up. And this one I like really did realize. I've always been very independent. I talked about being excited to go to college for the longest time, and now that I'm here, like, I really did realize there are a lot of things that I did at home that maybe I relied on my parents more, and now I kind of have to grow up and do it myself. So that's just something to keep in mind. The next one goes out to any high schoolers watching this video. AP scores really do help. I came in with at least 24 credits, and I'm a semester ahead, which is absolutely amazing. I didn't have to take a lot of gen eds that a lot of people do not like to take. So if you have the opportunity to take an AP test, I would take that AP test. It saves money, it saves time, it feels great to have a lot done. I don't have to spend my entire first year getting gen eds done, and I can really start diving into my major, so that's really important too. And if you didn't know, I am a news media major and a psych minor. I'm probably gonna try to dive into the news media a little bit and kind of pick a concentration, but for right now, I'm just doing the broad news media major. So in case you didn't know, that is what my major is. The next one's kind of leading off what I was just talking about with classes, and I said you can find classes that are actually interesting to you. When you pick courses at any school you go to, I would encourage you to really look into them and like find out what the curriculum is like, because there are a lot of classes that are very specific, but they're very unique in that way, and a lot of people with specific interests are drawn to these classes more, which I think is really awesome. And I think sometimes, obviously, you have to take the gen eds that you can't really get out of, the things that are a little bit more broad in topic and things like that, but you can find classes that you really are interested in, and you can kind of pick and choose classes within a certain broad subject that you are interested in, which I think is awesome. So that is definitely some advice to keep in mind. The next one is more towards high schoolers. The work ethic you create in high school translate a lot into college. I have said this so many times to my parents, but I feel like I haven't had to change a thing that I do here, because I worked ahead a lot in high school. I was very attentive to my work. I planned a lot ahead. And I'm not saying you have to do that to be successful in college, because everyone is different. But it is definitely very, very helpful if you have a good work ethic and you're getting your work done in the way that is successful and you're not getting things in late, because that really does translate to college and you have a lot of the same motivations coming in here. So that's also really important. The next one is, if you end up in Greek life, embrace it and spend time there. Obviously, in case you didn't know, most of you probably do, I'm a Pi Beta Phi here at Alabama. I love it so much. The girls are so, so sweet and so much fun, and I really do love spending time there. My schedule this semester kind of sucks for Greek life because I miss all the meals at the house on Monday, Wednesday, Fridays. But when I do get a chance to get there, I really try to be, and I think it's so important, because spending time with your sisters and your friends in your sorority or fraternity, if you are a guy, is really, really important, and you form a lot of really good friendships just by spending time at the house and hanging out there. So highly recommend that also. The next one is get involved. I highly recommend this absolutely anywhere you go. It is so important for your resume, because you're trying to get a job at the end of college, and it's just really important to get involved. I obviously am really involved in Pi Phi, and I'm in Capstone Agency here, and if you don't know what that is, it's just a PR and advertising firm here on campus, entirely student run. It's absolutely amazing, and it's like so much fun. Everyone is so nice, so hardworking. It's a really great group of people. I've just started the semester. I got in as a freshman, which is awesome. I would just urge you guys to get involved if there's like an extracurricular fair or something at your school, or here. I know we have one obviously in like August, September, but I would urge you to just sign up for things and see if you like them, and it will really help in the long run with resumes and stuff. Okay, this is one for specifically at Alabama. At Bama, for game days, you dress up. I always was like, oh, I'll just wear like ripped jeans and sneakers and like a cute shirt. Like, no, you wear dresses, skirts, like sets. You wear like bell-bottom jeans and sweaters. Like, it is very dressed up. Guys wear like polos and khakis, and some wear suits. The pledges wear suits. It's crazy. You really do dress up here. If you are coming here next year, I definitely, definitely want you to know that, because that is a big thing down south that I feel like people know, but they don't understand to the extent. At least I didn't, so that is really important as well. The next one is, if you're debating rushing, especially at Alabama, do it. I was in that same position. I was kind of debating whether or not to rush. I was like, I don't know if I want to do that. I was like, I'm more of like a chill laid back person. Like, I don't know if I'm gonna like a sorority. I didn't know if it was for me. And I can say with full confidence that it was completely for me. You really do end up at the place that you're meant to end up at, in the sorority you're meant to end up at. And a lot of their values and their personality really do match up with yours. So I would just encourage you even to rush. If you don't have to join one, if you don't want to, but it is a really good opportunity to make friends and to find that like really good group of people right off the bat in school, especially here, because we rush before school even starts. It's a really good way to make friends right away. So I definitely do recommend that if you are coming here or if you're going to another school. The next one is, stock up on medicine before coming to school. When sick season comes around, it will sell out. I came to school with a medicine bag and just things that I knew that I would need, like when I get a cold and stuff. I'm honestly sick right now. I have DayQuil in my medicine drawer. But things like that are just really important to have when it becomes winter and flu season kicks in and everyone's getting sick. The medicine is sold out. Like, you cannot find it. It's absolutely insane. So if you want to just be prepared, I recommend that also. The next one is, go to class. This sounds really stupid. A lot of high schoolers are probably like, I go to school 8 classes, 8 hours a day, and I'm totally fine. When you are in college, it gets harder to want to go to class, because you are just, you want to sleep and there are other things going on and you have to study for other tests and you're like, why do I have to go to class? Really go to class, because it does help in the long run. I'm doing very, very well here in school because I'm going to class. Just keep that in mind. The last one is a little bit of a kind of weird one, but it's related to academics. Use Rate My Professor. It helps a lot. I obviously, prior to coming to school, we picked our schedules at Bama Bound, and I didn't know about it, and I had to pick my schedule for the semester, and I was kind of nervous. I was like, I don't know who to take, what to take. I was like freaking out. Rate My Professor basically just gives you a lowdown of every teacher, what their style's like, what you can expect from them, and that is super important, and you can kind of match up with teachers based on what you think you would succeed best in. So I definitely recommend that as well. Okay, you guys, that is everything for what I wish I knew before my first semester of college. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please give this video a big thumbs up, hit the subscribe button down below, and so I know if you guys want me to do one at the end of the year to compare this video to that one, let me know in the comments, or like this video also would be a good way to let me know. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I will see you guys next time.